as a medium that I enjoy, I did a video about the weird world of Into the Horror back in April, and that video did very well. So, and this is sort of a sequel slash spin-off of that video, and the title and thumbnail might reveal the topic at hand, which hit Disturbed and startled me. Be warned that these videos tackle very, very disturbing and mature things that someone that gets easily disturbed or upset should not watch the video. This is your, basically, turn back now. Basically, you've got this disclaimer at the start of the video, and now this is this disclaimer at the beginning of the video. So, yeah, so be warned, this tackles very disturbing things, and I'll be talking about some sensitive stuff, so obviously there'll be hotlines down in the description about it. So, yeah, this is just, be warned that this tackles very tricky stuff, so yeah, be warned. And let's begin with the Legacy Flash games. The Legacy Flash games were created by Ghost Tundra, a talented animator that was on YouTube but started uploading around 3 years ago during COVID. And in October 2022, she uploaded the first of Legacy's Flash games called Legacy's Wardrobe. The video begins with the start screen making it look like an old Flash game that you would play on the internet, and it switches to the next room where it tells the player the story and what you need to do. Legacy has a busy day today. In the morning, she will attend a picnic in the park. Then, in the afternoon, she must go shopping. Finally, she must have a date night with the cutest guy. Phew! But there is only one problem. She has no idea what to wear. Can you help Legacy put together the cutest outfits for each situation? Then it switches to the dressing up minigame. By choosing the hairstyles and clothes, then she has a picnic in the park. But you feel a sense of unease due to the figure in the forest hiding and watching Legacy. Then it switches to the minigame again about getting ready to the mall, but there is a phone call.
Legacy, I can wait to meet up, Legacy. I want to have a good time tonight with you, Legacy. Tonight, bye bye.
This gets unsettling by the phone call by being a stalker, about a stalker. Excited for tonight, and the game glitching as well, and being darker, and the stalker being outside her window. He knows everything about her, and Legacy is scared and cries for help to the player, but it doesn't work. Then the final minigame has eerie music, and a persistent knocking from the stalker, and a gift for her that is censored, and he calls her about the gift and needing to open the door. Well, Legacy tries to tell the player to not go outside, but they don't listen, and leads her to her demise. It's revealed that the stalker killed her and ate her remains to show as a show of love, and it ends on this dark note. I wasn't kidding that this gets disturbing, but this is the first video out of three, and it gets way, way more darker than this. Onto Legacy's Diner. It begins with a disclaimer about the video, very fitting, and it shows a person loading the game, and there is someone communicating with us, which is the player, with black text, telling us that there is a secret ending in one of Legacy's Flash games, documenting it. Then the menu loads, and it shows on what to do. Legacy is about to open her brand new diner. However, she needs your help to keep up with so many hungry customers. How to play? Add the correct items to Legacy's request into the main bowl. When you're done, it's time to serve the customers. However, don't take too long. You know how people get when they're hungry. Then it switches to the cooking minigame, where the player tells that there is a timer and says that you need to have enough time to do the minigame, but then fast forwards to the timer running out. Then the player clicks Legacy and starts making the dish. When it reaches 10 seconds, it starts to glitch and corrupts, and says, says to hurry up, and the player does this, and we are rewarded with making stroganoff with baked rice. Then it switches to the info screen on serving to the customer. Then the player serves the food to the customers and tells us that they are going to do this three more times to get the normal ending, and shows a win screen on and completing the game. Then we cut to the player running out of time in a new game, and the game crops and shows an image dated 06/29/2006 at the 29th of whatever day, so probably June or July 2006, with Lacey not looking too hot. The word stupid, useless, slow, the F word, and she could say the F word, and failure, with an image of a knife in frame. Then it cuts back to the dining area, and there is an eerie silence, and says, "You took too long, and the customers have left," and shows an end screen of Lacey being sad, and that then there is a different scene. Then the player warns us that it gets worse and repeats the same thing they did before by letting the timer run out, and Lacey disappears and reappears, not looking too good, and shows a creepy image of Lacey with the words failure repeating over and over. Then there are quick flashes of notes and places that Lacey has been. Then it's back to the dining hall, and then to the end screen, where Lacey talks to the player and us that she hates her life and the people in her diner, and will show something to them. Then the world is warped, and things like cigarette butts, drugs, and a cockroach, poin, a condom, glass, and her father, which is one of. With each one dragged to the ball, shows how Lacey feels about it, and the final thing we see is her father smiling. We do not see what Lacey has made, but we don't need to know. And the player feeds the warped patrons in Silent Hill. Obviously, Silent Hill, can you not tell because of the landscape? And we see Lacey's diner has closed, and Lacey bruised and defeated. And she says, "This is it." And then it cuts to the alleyways where the center body of Lacey lays, resulting in the bad ending, and showing a brief flashes of Lacey back to the main menu, and the player closing off the video that ends Lacey's diner, onto the final one so far, which is Lacey's pet shop. It begins with another warning, and Lacey shows up with an iPod, and music starts to play, then switches to another file called Grace 01 MP3, and Grace talks about the Lacey games and her involvement and not knowing why this is happening, and is told to play Lacey's Pet Shop, and it goes to the title and shows the instructions. Lacey has one of the most famous pet shops on town. People come from all over to buy her perfect little furry companion, and it will be your job to help her today. Instructions: listen to the client's animal demands, then sew the items on the bottom row to customize them and get them all ready for the new and loving homes. Remember, the animals from Lacey's Pet Shop should always be perfect for the new owners. Good luck. Obviously, I'm going to butcher some stuff, and this is just me in recording, so, because some of the lines in this are actually wrong. They are spelled incorrectly, or there are mistypos, which kind of adds to the effect. So it's not my fault, I'm fairly certain. Maybe I wrote something in the script, but this, slurring my words, because, anyway, this is just like me briefly talking about it. Yeah. On to continuing. Then it shows the mini games of of the customer asking for an animal, and Grace makes them perfect until a person asks for a French hamster with a very long neck, and she does it. The music starts to break while this happens. Then the person asking for a doll with human teeth, and the person wants to buy a bunny with no ears, legs, and tail. She does this, then a creepy dog shows up and corrupts the game. And we see Lacey naked with human eyes watching. Then a weird twisted world where it becomes a point-and-click game and reminds me of Rambo. If you played Rambo, people who made Little Miss Fortune, they made a prior game called Rambo, which I want to make a video at some point. I will, eventually. But they made a previous game, which is Rambo, which was their first game, and it reminds me of this, so of a twisted version of reality emerging. So like two perspectives of reality and stuff, and colliding and stuff. I really want to do a video of Rambo. I'll do that eventually. This is just like little tease or explaining, yeah. This reminds me of this. Lacey questions where is she and sees a house but could not pass due to a skeleton cat speaking to her and telling her that she needs his skin back and goes to find and goes left and finds the skin and goes back to give it goes back to give it to the cat and enters the house. We see stairs up and rooms to the right and left with strange paintings on the wall. We cannot go into the room upstairs due to needing key, and she goes left and sees pigs eating and intrudes, and they are staring and a flash of a story and a picture of a dog. Then the pigs are gone. Then she goes to the right and sees a broken living room with a cage within it. And Lacey enters it and feels that she likes it and finds the key for the upstairs. Then she has visions of a dog and she goes upstairs and opens the door and finds a choice of room 1 or 2 or a bathroom. She enters the bathroom and takes a look in the mirror and she sees the real version of the person trying to speak to Lacey or the player. When it breaks and Lacey is forced to go back and then Then it goes to the room 1 where her room is and sees vision of a dead dog and making it go very statically, and it cuts to a real life shot or IRL shot where Lacey wants a cat revealing the truth and shows the dead dog and talking about it attacking her and Lacey having tendencies to get rid of it. Then she goes back and goes to the room 2 where it is a strange room, like a cave with candles, and finds matches and lights the match.
For years it was bad to meet the round 2. Where the bad sense becoming too visible in this game. We are afraid about the serious things, but now, when this time is back, I was the dog that bit his neck.
It was all a dream, but you can see the body of the dog below her bed. And it ends with Gracie's closing MP3 called Grace 05 MP3. A form of hello from a mysterious person. And that's how the video ends. So you might be wondering what the story might be. I will share my theories and speculation on it and a conclusion on the series so far and overall. So yeah, this is my closing theory slash analysis, like what I think the story is so far. So yeah, enjoy. So my thinking of the story is that two developers called Bracey and Rico made a website called Lacey's Games, which you can access in real life, by the way, because I found it, with the cast of Lacey, Macy, and Jay, where people could play games, basically. Gracie and Rico stopped making them until 2007 because of the timestamp in the bottom of the page says 2004 to 2007, so that's where feels like the game just ended. Where Gracie mentions at the end of Lacey's pet shop, they split off around 2010, and she hasn't heard from her since. So we don't know if it takes place like in 2020 or whatever, but we know like 3 years after something happened and they split off. Then a couple of years later, someone finds Lacey's games and the old like flash game things, and they decide to document it. We don't know if Gracie has documented Wardrobe and Dinah, but we know Dinah is someone else, not Gracie, because if it was Gracie, we would know. So it must be some other person documenting this. And then Lacey game, and like Fitch finds the .content and documents it, and Gracie gets complaints from parents and people about like, this is scary for children and you should investigate it. And she does Lacey's pet shop and she sees the truth for herself, and she suspects that, oh, she did these sick things because, I don't know, she wants to. Well, there's like some entity somewhat in the website where it says hello at the end of pet shop. We still don't know. But that's just my like overarching like theory of like the human side, but within the game side, I'm gonna talk about now. With Lacey's story, it begins with Lacey being in an abusive household due to the cage in the living room. Due to saying that she was not forced to go in there and did it by choice, and being isolated in her house and not being allowed to eat or go and go into the cage if she misbehaved, and dreaming of a better life symbolic of the cats, and hates her family and sees them as pigs due to eating and eating while Lacey gets nothing or something from time to time, and she takes it out on the dog, eventually killing it. That's just my hypothesis. It could be completely wrong, but that's my first thought, because of the cage, the dog died somehow, but she wants a cat still, so, and the pigs probably reflect of her, like, parents or something like that. She's basically not treated kindly in this world. And also not happy with herself due to the mirror and reflection of Simon trying to talk to her, if it was, like, the developers or something like that. Still don't have no idea, because it's muffled and I can't hear anything, so on that. But she's not happy with herself. And then one day she decides to get some matches and burns the house down entirely to it, which I can see is symbolic in pet shop. She just burns the house down, her parents possibly die, and she leaves and becomes homeless, or she goes into the care system where, like, if you don't know what the care system is, or the adoption system where, like, you're just in, like, a specific care of, like, carers, where, like, you're under a certain age where you can't actually you're not legally an adult, so someone has to look after you, so she goes probably in drone foster systems. And just my hypothesis, because you see different houses and different stuff. But from her abuse, like, I'm just, like, trying to link this to, like, abusive relationship, and I just, like, I don't know why I'm thinking Harley Quinn, but, like, leads her to watching and reading pornography, smoking, unsafe sex, and self-harm, and as, like, coping, or basically from that abuse, she just, like, has these things as coping mechanisms, or she does them as specific things because she's mistreated or something like that, and she just carries that burden for a long time. Which I've reflected in Lacey's Dino, but still remembering her father, because you usually remember your abuse. Usually, I'm not a therapist, don't count me in that, I'm not a therapist, but usually people who are abused have like some trauma related to the abuser, which obviously her father could have been the abuser, and she remembers her father. And like being reminded as a cockroach of useless, pathetic, and waste of space, basically cockroaches being a pest to her family, basically. And Lacey's Dime is just like metaphorical, that dream sequence, that the Silent Hill section is sort of just like her life things, but I sort of relate that to basically it starts working out a diner for some money, but her violent tendencies like self-harm and other stuff, she just leads to having worse conditions, like two like staff and patrons, and then Minsky gets fired, which I kind of see like at the end of Dino. She's worthless and she's wanders around and wishes that someone can help her, but no one listens. And until she has a relationship with someone, I'm trying to link this with Wardro, because Wardro is like the weird one, because it doesn't fit anywhere. But it turns into a beast one, because it's all, there is some psychology and some, not philosophy, but yeah, some psychology where like, if you're abused, you form attachments to people who are abusers. because that's all you know as attachment. So you technically gravitate to people who are abusive. So yeah, in terms of abusive and during very and basically being very persistent and not leaving you alone, so basically being annoying, and resulting into in this turmoil while an entity shows that the relationships can end badly, working 9 to 5 and will break you. Having a pet can be rewarding, also annoyance. And it might spread to other annoyance and and it might spread to other girls like Macy and Jay, which we don't not know yet. If they're part of it due to Lacey not having an image or a fourth person. And a fourth person in called cute in the source code, which is a creepy image, which I'm gonna show you right now. It's just a creepy image. I'm like quickly just like checking like on the website, yeah, Lacey does not have an image. It's just a broken image, so that means that Lacey does not exist anymore, or she has suffered enough. I don't know how, and NC has something to do with it. This is just my ramblings on. So this is my shot of theory. I don't want to be right, I don't want to be wrong, but this is just my thought process of what I got. And I feel like there are going to be more stories about Macy and Jay. They might have some involvement. We do not know, but onto like, this is still my theory, my game for film theory. Yeah, film theory. Basically, this is just my like sort of pseudo theory, which don't take me as fact, because there's other people who've done more research in this. I did just light research and other stuff. Obviously, they're linked in the description on the iCard above, like Lacey's games explained, like. Explain the story, but like all the things as well. So, yeah, take it with a grain of salt. I'm just gonna talk about what I like about the show. Then, at the end, there will be a surprise if you stick about long enough about talking about some personal stuff. So, yeah, onto the conclusion. So yeah, this is my conclusion. So these are a wonderful set of videos. A very unique due to Flash Game Horror, which I don't know if it's actually ever done before, because everyone does VHS, Analog Horror, and some Creepypasta stuff and EXE, but no one actually does Flash Games, which is kind of interesting, because I actually like Flash Games and stuff. I'm planning on doing a video on a specific franchise of Flash Games, which I will cover eventually, but yeah, no one actually does horror on Flash Games, which is so unique about it, and really deserves a praise on it. Her channel will be in the description, by the way, so and I actually will subscribe to her as well, because her content interests me, and as a person who likes art and horror stuff, this sort of like blends together. And to see if she continues on with Lexi Games. I don't know if this is like just a one-off thing that she wants to do, like an ARG, pseudo ARG, and or she's planning more stuff, because she actually has another series going on currently, which is I'm excited for. I want to check it out. So like this is sort of like the Lexi Games saga, as it is. I don't know if they're going to continue. As I mentioned before, the website is a real thing. As I mentioned previously, I found while randomly researching, and I used bits and pieces during my theory. And links of the website will be in the description. So any avid lore hunters, you can take a crack at it, or other stuff. So yeah, check a character and watch the videos, because possibly my platform Game Theory will cover this eventually if enough spotlight is brought to this, because I did my Weird World of Insta Horror and I included Welcome Home before MatPat did. Before MatPat did a video, any video on it, I did it before MatPat. I'm like, MatPat, you have to ruin something. But I think this is somewhat underground, because if you're in specific niches, like, these videos get, like, a lot of videos. I saw about later games. Like, we get decent views. So I'm not happy going on the bandwagon. Sorry. On that train, because I'm not interested in, like, trends and stuff. I'm just interested in talking about interesting stuff. How many times did I say that word? Every single time I repeat a word. But, yeah. That's just, like, I want to cover things I find interesting. because this thing is right up my alley. And a lot of people don't talk about it. If this brings my MatPat's attention, then, like, I'm just going to be doomed. Why can't we have anything pure? Because Welcome Home, I have some faith. And I mentioned it in my Instant Horror, that if my MatPat comes to theory, I'm going to, like, cry. Yeah, so this is one review out of many. So this is the first review because out of two in October. So I can record this in September because I actually want to get I want to relax a bit in October. So yeah, so this is going to be the first part. So just like this video, then another one about movies and FNAF related. So be a lookout for that. So yeah, like, I'm wondering, no, it's not about the FNAF movie, because I'm gonna watch it. I'll watch it, but yeah. So you have two reviews in a month, which will be surprising. So yeah, this is the first one. So the second one will be FNAF adjacent and something to do with film. So yeah, be ready for that one. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and see you in the next one. Bye. Hey, you stuck around. Very great, very great. So this is just like talking about where I've been, because at the time of this recording, it would have been like basically a month without like any new content, because obviously you would have basically got something about a video game collection, which I'm actually passionate about, so I want to slowly get that started. And basically some Lego Star Wars Skywalker Saga stuff, like doing the sequels, because I edited and recorded them. I recorded and edited them like months ago, and I just forgot to upload them, so you get those to finish that one off. So yeah. So where I've been, like, I think if you're on my Twitter or looking at my community time, basically I said that, like, I was working on a review on Transformers 2007, and I had, like, a lot of copyright issues, and I'm trying to fix it, and, you know, back and forth, and it's just annoying. But eventually I will try to get it done. Not the way I wanted to, but, like, in a state where it's complete, and it doesn't get copyrighted. But I still have, like, the original file and stuff. So I will basically try to prevent it. So I'll basically try to, like, work in a way. So, like, I'll probably put it on, like, a Google Drive or something like that. Where, like, probably in the link in the description, you just see, like, the Google Drive to, like, the original video. Because I don't actually have a Patreon. I would like to have a Patreon. So I can just put those on Patreon when you subscribe for all this. A specific amount you probably get access to that on this video. So yeah, I'll probably mention it when I like work some stuff with like their editing. So yeah, that's where I've been trying to sort that out, and I sort of lost creativity, or like basically burnt out, like, and the schedule has changed. So it's because I can record at certain times, but it's just like very weirdly structured, and like if I'm doing like a 2-hour video or a 1-hour video or something like that, I won't be able to do it at all. Like, I actually won't be. And it's just like, not pains me, but it's just like, annoying to do. But it'll be like more focused on like reviews if I can. November, I don't think, I'm not sure if I'm going to do review. I probably might take a break. Probably might take a break. If you're wondering time, like, oh, are you going to do Resident Evil 4 remake DLC? Maybe. I might do it in like, at the time of this like upload would be like early October, so probably... Yeah, probably December, like around Christmas time. I know I'll be like very late, like a couple of months late. Because either way, I was with RE4 Remake as well, so I ended up like a month late. Because I wasn't happy like streaming with it. Same with Gotham Knights. I did one stream around the game around the time the game came out, I just went back to it like months later. And that'd be like the series I would send out, and like, it's not the best game, but yeah. About LEGO Monster Bros. 2, I might go back to it, I just don't like the game. So I don't want to like painstakingly go through it. But I will try. I will try to like play through it, so. And it's just like extra like 5 minutes of rambling. So this is just like my thoughts. So there'll be less gameplay. What happened to the Dying Light video, if you might be wondering. I just took it down because I wasn't happy with it. I was happy with my commentary. I actually like that commentary, but like the game, the frames were just like not good. Dying Light, like, it's not optimized very good for recording, so just like you have frame dips for no reason. And like, I think I sorted the issue out. Yeah, I sorted the issue out. It's just like the game just like has to, but eventually like YouTube will just upscale it and like make it a tiny bit better. So you win some or you lose some. So, that's it. This is like at the end, like the small update. So, but there won't be like regular videos. So, like any videos that like I've got in my backlog, I probably might upload or something. I'll just basically focus more on reviews and stuff. So, yeah, and I'm more focused on like my life because I was like more flexible of doing it in. Last year, but around like this year, sort of changed like at the start of like the end of this year and up to next year, it sort of like changed. So, I want to focus more on my life than YouTube, but I still upload casually if I can because I uploaded like nearly like 300 videos, or on the time will be like 300 videos, not 300, 200, and like less growth. So I would like to basically just rectify that and like focus more on reviews because that's what my intentional version of the channel was meant to be. So yeah, happy Halloween, as this is a Halloween upload, so yeah, happy Halloween and see you in the next review, which will be in basically a week or two. So yeah, hope you enjoy and see you next one. Bye!